Hello and welcome to part number 7, Forced Perspective in Camera Projection. And that sounds like double trouble, and the truth is maybe beyond that. So if you are pretty new to camera projection, this might confuse you more than it helps you. But the truth is, sometimes we have to cheat things to give a certain impression. And of course, a forced perspective is pretty old school, but not old school in camera projection. This is something that I have developed, and I want to share this, of course, with you. Okay, before I go further, I want to go here and open that window, and then you can see the picture. What I have here normally, and let's pretend for a moment that we have just walls here, straight walls, no errors or something like that, just straight. Then we could reproduce the whole scene, if we exclude here these little guys, just with three planes. That means two verticals and one horizontally flat in the middle. Let's presume that for a moment. And these would be then exactly intersecting where we have this line here and where we have this line here. That is the theory, and that is how we do it normally when we want to reproduce exactly what we have seen in the first place. Okay. Now it comes. What I want to show you here is, of course, what happens if I just say, okay, that's not flat. I change it. I do a forced perspective on it, which is old school, but in a way, we do it here. It's not old school, it's new. Or at least I show you that here, maybe the first time. When you have an eye on these lines here that we have inside of that plane, you see how it moves here along with the lines in the picture, as it should. And then we have a rotational point here. That means we get this point from the door more into the plane, and this we get in a different way. Let's have a look. This is after, and this is before. After and before. And you might say, okay, I can't see the picture here. It doesn't change at all. Only the plane with the lines change. So what's the big deal? The big deal is that this line here is projected on this plane, and this edge here where the planes would intersect moves inside of the picture in a huge way. To make that more visible, I have given you here another plane. And now you can see why I have put in these horrible colors to make it really clear. Where these edges are, the color changes. So let's have a look. When I move now the floor plane, I have to change this one here also to get here this edge, and it's not really there. So let's have a look to that. I want to change this, of course, so I have to move it back even and rotate it a little bit, and you can see how that works. Okay, so now I move this back here. Okay, move that also a little bit, go back to the plane and put it in. Rotate it a little bit and you see how it works. And I can do that all day. So now you can see what is going on here. To stay in this intersection here of these two planes, I have to move now both. They are dependent on each other. And exactly there, the perspective changes, of course, as you can see that here in the picture. To make that a little bit more visible but more confusing, perhaps I have created here something that looks like these cubes here. Okay, and here you can see how much I have to move these cubes, and then I change, of course, the depths here. One time it's in this way and one time it is in that way, so they get projected much longer into space here. And you see now this edge here covers also that other building, and now it doesn't. And that changes, of course, the perspective, the depth impression, and all of that when I move now the camera. And that is part of the scene that I have created. And so I cheat a little bit the depth perspective, so it looks longer, but it is, in truth, it's not that long. Okay, thanks for listening. Have fun with it.